Hello and welcome to Marks of Distinction. Today we are going to work on a seat switch.
Yeah.
I don't want Craig's car beating mine.
One issue that comes up with these is especially if you live in a saltwater climate, but even for regular maintenance, you should at least do this at least once every 5 years. Many cars have burnt down because the contacts in here, they're powered all the time. So even when the key's off, unless you disconnect the battery, this is always getting power. Therefore, if the contacts are bad in there and they spark one of these days, they're going to catch on fire and your car is going to burn down. Or at least be ruined enough where you're going to have a bad day. What we'll do here is we're going to take this out of here, get in the back, pull it apart, and then we'll go from there and show you. Now, you don't need to put it into a vise like I did, but the problem is when you got to film with one hand and use this for the other, it makes it a little bit hard. All right, now we got it out of here. Got it out of there. Now our next step is to remove the top from the base, which most of the time, this is still in your car. So actually when you do remove it out of here, you're actually separating this and the car. Usually what you have to do is take a little screwdriver and just slowly put it in between those things and pry apart. And voila, this is what you're left with. Now, sometimes you're able to save this outer rubber sleeve, but most of the time you're not. Once you start pulling it apart, it kind of goes to a pot. Now, on the underside, it looks okay here, but sometimes they look really good here, but then when you get into the top, they're just absolutely awful. So let's pull this apart. Again, one-handed, you gotta love it. Then you just slowly pull it above. And right now, as you're doing this and you're not wanting to mess anything up, you can use some choice words if you want to. But since this is YouTube, I am unable to. And I'm trying to show you the real struggle here in real time so you know how absolutely wonderful it is. Ta-da! And I will actually be able to reuse this. There is some breaking there, but this is good enough to be reused. So I will set that guy over there. And all right, now we're looking on the inside, which right now it doesn't look too bad. Okay, now we'll get on to the project. Now for all the items you're gonna need for this job is one, you're gonna need a seat controller. That's kind of a given. Then you're gonna need a screwdriver, a tiny little guy. So that way you can pop this stuff out later to get in there and clean it really good. And you're gonna need some sandpaper. And it does not matter if it's silicone free or not, because once you go in there and clean all the contacts, you're going to be washing it away. So it does not matter. Does not matter at all. And you're gonna need a little bigger screwdriver just in case, because sometimes these can be a little bit of a bear to pull out. Then you're gonna need a container, you're going to need the dielectric grease at the end of the job to fill it all up. But then you're going to need a container. You don't need to have a glass one. All you need is one big enough to submerge this item into there. That's all you need. So not very much. Now, the guy that's going to do most of the work, the distilled white vinegar. Why use distilled white vinegar? Because it's sterile and I like the taste. Now, it works good on electronics. You can do that on any type of electronic. It gets rid of any corrosion. It's really good. All right, you want to fill it up till it gets above the highest point at first. All right, now one thing you want to do is at the beginning and about every 15 minutes. Overall, you want this set between an hour and 2 hours in the bath. But every like 15 minutes, you come up and you move around each of these connectors. But do that while you're in here and move them around several different times, about once every 15 minutes. And you want to let it sit in there for about an hour to 2 hours, give or take, depending how bad it is. Now, honestly, this doesn't look too bad in there. And the contacts, I don't know if you can really, yeah, not really. But the contacts actually look really good overall on this thing. And I mean, it's cleaning up really good. So it probably didn't need to stay in here too long. But in all honesty, I'm going to leave it in here for an hour just to see how it is. And like I said, every 15 minutes, you come up here and wiggle those things around while it's in the bath. All right, hopefully you can see this. You want to take this screwdriver and go in these little spots right here, slowly pry out. And therefore, it pops out. I'm gonna do that for this one. It's a non-directional piece. You can put it back either way. These ones sometimes are a little bit harder. Yep, popped it up. Popped out. Not seeing anything broken, so that's good. But on all these pieces here, you want to look in between there, make sure there's no gunk in there. So what you'll do is take this sandpaper, just fold it over. You'll have to cut it down smaller, but then go through each one of these contacts. There's four on this front one and two on each of these back ones. Once you place it back in the water, you'll want to push down on each of the flanges several times to get the contacts to get the vinegar in there to start working on it. And let that do for about 20 minutes. Come back to it every few minutes, keep on doing the same thing, and when you pull it out, we'll be done. Now, we'll hook up the air. Now that one has blown it all out, you want to take some dielectric grease and put on each of the pivot points. You want to get little blobs of it. And put around each of the connection points. Also some of the pivot points, just so it pivots a little bit easier. And then it'll be time to put these in. This piece here is a square. So when you put these in, make sure it lines up exactly In the middle of this guy, as you can see, is a square. After making sure that this square is lined up properly in there, you gotta bring this around where it lines up with one there. And you take this screwdriver, and then hopefully, all right, pops in. So as you go around, everything's like it should. Now for these back ones, you don't have to make sure they line up at all. But then you want to get this one ready. Because these, if this piece is still good enough, you got to be able to fit these around here, and those are always a little bit of a pain. Then as you go in and pull around it, okay, now it fits in nice. Same thing with this guy here. Okay, now you want to roll these up on the edges so that way it's easier to get them in. Like so. Therefore, it looks like a little cup. Isn't that pretty? All right. Now, on each of these, you want to be able to fit them in. And usually, they press in pretty easily. Let's see. You got to get the inner piece one in there first. All right. That one's in. Make sure that inner piece right in there is in there first. Like they say, make sure it finds its happy place. And you push it down and in. All right. Now on these back ones, let's roll it back over. Then, all right. Voila. You now have, you could say rebuilt, but a lot of the rebuilders, that's exactly what they do. But it's at least a reconditioned seat switch that has been cleaned, lubricated, and is now ready to be put in service for use. Closing thoughts. As you saw, it's extremely simple to go into one of these, fix it, clean it, not only for restoring it, but also every few years just to do that to make sure this doesn't cause your car to burn down. There are so many people out there that charge $100 to $200 to restore one of these. And what you saw here is exactly what they do. So save yourself a lot of money by paying $7 for this, $10 for this. And with this stuff here, you could probably redo 100 of these suckers. So instead of paying a whole lot of money, just do this. And it's simple, it's easy. If you have any questions, please let me know. Please like and subscribe. Thank you very much. Bye.